This is the BougeRV 2000W Pure Sine Wave 12V Inverter with Bluetooth. Let's dive into it. If you've been around my channel for any length of time, you will know that I love this 800W inverter, but it just doesn't cut it for some of the things that we're wanting to do. Now, any inverter like this that you can clamp onto batteries is gonna be a vital part of preparedness, and it allows you to take energy from your car or a stored battery system, assuming it's 12 volts, and actually convert that into usable energy when you need it. But what makes the BougeRV's 2000W inverter different from this one right here? Well, this one's really old, and number one, this is 800 watts, and this is 2000 watts. This unit can come in 1000, 2000, and 3000, and they all basically do the same thing. However, unlike this old one, these are made specifically to work with lithium iron phosphate batteries, which is huge because, as most of you know, the technology is moving away from the old lead acid batteries and into the lithium style. So you're gonna want a new inverter that's gonna communicate with them better. It'll keep you from ending up having BMS errors where you draw too much power too quick and you end up shutting the battery down and it doesn't work at all. The next thing is, unlike this old one, the BougeRV has Bluetooth capabilities built straight into it. So from your phone, you can monitor the health of your battery. You can check out the load. You can see all the information that you want at a glance. In addition to that, if you don't want to connect the app, which honestly, I don't like connecting all of my devices to my phone, you have the ability to run a 20-foot cable to a monitor that you can place on your wall. Say you've got this thing in the back of an RV, you can run this cable all the way to wherever you need this to be mounted, and you can see at a glance the status of your system. So let's go ahead and hook this thing up to a battery and see what we can get. It looks like these caps right here pop off. It's pretty simple. One goes up, one goes down. Got a lock washer, a washer, and a nut. So I'm gonna start off, it's gonna be 13 millimeter. I don't know what the torque spec is. I didn't see it in the instructions. Put this cap back on there, flip over and do the same thing to the other side. Put on the cable washer, followed by the lock washer, followed by the nut. Cap goes back on. I like this system here. This is actually pretty nice. And there's virtually no way you're gonna end up causing like a short circuit there. You don't want these guys to touch, although nothing happened right there. Still don't want that to happen. Now that we've got that set up, let's get it connected to a battery. Connect up the positive first. Ooh. A little bit of singeing there. Ooh, I didn't like that. All right. Always make sure it's turned off. In this case, it was. Once we've got the battery connected, then we can go ahead and turn it on. Then we've got our two AC outlets, our 15 amp and our 20 amp. And we've got our terminals on the front right here where we can go ahead and hardwire into our RV or right into our panel. Let's also go ahead and hook up this communications cable. Okay, instantly powers up. Pull this off. That's actually a really nice display. I like that. It's super bright. I didn't expect it to be that nice. So it's showing our output at 120 volts. The wattage is zero. The battery temperature is 25 Celsius. It'd be nice if we could switch that over to Fahrenheit. And it shows that the input battery is at 13.1 volts. I'm gonna go ahead and look over here. It is showing that the inverter itself is pulling 10 watts from the battery. We're not gonna see that here because we're not getting 10 watts out the front, but the standby is just 10 watts. So that's good to know. Let's fire something up. So of course, what are we gonna power first? The heat gun. I'm gonna plug into the 25 amp outlet. Turn on. Fans have kicked on the BougeRV units. Let's show them we're putting out 1,097 watts, 1,100 watts. If we look over here, we're drawing 1,300 watts. So 1,100 watts, 1,300 watts, 200 watts is being eaten up by the inverter and inefficiency. So let's see if we can sustain 2000 watts for, let's say, 2 minutes. I'm gonna plug this in. I've got it plugged into my charge inverter, which is right down here, and it's powering the batteries that are currently powering our entire homestead. So 2000 watts, when I turn this on, it's going to slowly ramp up. And we're going to watch together and see what happens. I actually don't know if this unit can put out 2000 watts. That might be our limiting factor. Yeah, I don't know that the Orion can do 2000 watts continuous. We'll see. We're at 1000 watts. So far, the fan hasn't even kicked on at 1000 watts. There it goes. Actually, that was at 800 watts here. 1400, 1500 watts. All right, we tripped. But I think it was this unit here. So I'm going to look and see if we're getting 12 volts. We're only getting 2 volts. So the problem is we tripped the BMS on this battery. So I got to figure out how we get this battery back online. Bummer. Well, after dealing with it for a couple of minutes, the BMS reset whenever I took the load off and then disconnected it and then tested it again. Now I'm back to my 13 volts. However, the max output for this in wattage is just over 1200 watts, and I knew that, but I forgot about it. So unfortunately, I don't have any other 12 volt batteries here that I can test to see if we can hit 2000 watts, which is really a bummer. Okay, you know, I just remembered one thing that we can do is we can set up a test to check out the surge capabilities, see if we can run the air conditioner in here. So I'm going to go ahead and plug this in. And when I turn it on, the AC is going to try to start up. So we're going to look at this. All right, I'm showing 600 watts output. It must have had a surge, though, because it's an air conditioner. That's what it does. When that pump kicks on, it has a pretty high surge. So that was kind of cool that we're actually running the air conditioner in here, but very smooth. This thing seemed to handle it really well, and I think that's great. I decided that I actually had a battery that was capable of this. I actually have two batteries in my big old F250 here. We've got two of these AGM batteries, and I went ahead and connected right here. And so we should be good to go. Before we do that, let's go ahead and sign into the app. I've just downloaded the app for the first time. So I've got right here, you'll see it on the screen. UI interface fully upgraded, that's great. Okay, it's more user-friendly, that's fantastic. Learn more. Okay, I guess try now is what you have to push. Okay, so what I wanna do, please log in. Let's go visitor login. Can we just do that? Because one of the things is I hate having to actually like register with like a company to go in and just use the product. Can we just upload or download the app and just start using it? Like, please, I hate this whole let's create a login thing. I already have a device. Please log in. See, this is frustrating. I don't like this. All right, so create an account. Let's go scan for a nearby device. I guess I need to turn this thing on. So there it is. That was quick. Connect. New equipment. You can learn about this equipment through the teaching videos. That's cool. Maybe you guys can check that out. Skip. Here we go, we're gonna jump onto it. I must say, aside from having to register this, which just makes me frustrated, the app is really nice. Like, the user interface is really smooth. I like the design. It seems to be very easy to follow. All right, so we've got our 120 volts, we're currently pulling 0 amps, and we're at 60 hertz, which is great. All right, device temperature is gonna be in Fahrenheit. I like that. Okay, so I guess the next thing for us to do is clear out some of this stuff over here.
and then we can set up a space heater or something. The goal right now is to try to break this thing and go over 2000 watts. We shouldn't have a problem doing that with a handful of heating elements. I'm gonna plug this one into the 20 amp outlet, and then we'll plug the heat gun into the 15 amp outlet. Looks like we're already going. Look at that. Looks like we're pulling, I'm hoping, what's, oh, battery voltage is low. I guess I should probably start my truck, huh? That's gonna make it tough to hear, but we'll do that.
All right, so now we've got 14 volts going. You can see in the app here. And we're gonna go ahead and turn on high. I think it's a lot happier about that, although the battery voltage is dropping for sure. All right, now let's grab the heat gun. I'm gonna put the heat gun on low. And let's see, oh, it's starting to squeal. All right, I'm seeing 17. I don't know if the battery can handle this. All right, I'm gonna go to high. Oh, and it stopped. Battery low voltage protection, dang. All right, I think I'm gonna let my truck idle for a while and get that battery back up. Maybe let's see if we can just like hammer it real fast. Let's see if we can do that. Can we get 2,000? Oh, we got 2,000. And then it died on us for, right there, battery low voltage protection. Dang. All right. I guess that's it for this test.
I think this is a fantastic inverter. It has got some really nice features. I like the fact that the app is super easy to use. It's like crazy simple and beautiful. Like as a designer, I love to see pretty apps. So that part is great. And not just the app is pretty, the entire brand is pretty. Look at all of their products and by the way, BougeRV has like so many different fridges. They've got the inverters, they've got batteries, dude, they've got a full line of stuff. I had no idea how extensive their lineup was, but it's pretty awesome. What I don't like, I really disliked having to create an account so that I could utilize the app. That part just bugs me like crazy. And when doing so, you can't use special characters, and it doesn't tell you you can't use special characters. So I was like banging my head up against the wall trying to like create a password. And well, I eventually got it and figured that out. So that part is a bit frustrating. Let me know your thoughts on that. Next, it does exactly what it's supposed to do. And it seems to be a really solid inverter that can handle as much power as you can throw at it. Now, unfortunately, I wasn't able to get in there and actually try 2000 watts for very long, but I did hit it for just a split second there with my truck. But this thing, there are so many different applications for it, whether it's something that you need a new inverter for your RV, or you need an inverter to run some stuff on an off-grid piece of property, or you want to use this one single inverter and need to be able to run your fridge for just a while. In that case, you can slap this thing onto your vehicle. I wanna go ahead and thank BougeRV for sending this thing out for me to review. It's been great. If there are any discount codes, I'm gonna put them down below. I'd really appreciate it if you're interested in buying this to use my link. That will be below as well. While they did send me the product for review, I always give my honest opinion about the things I like and the things I dislike. So you can trust me on that. If you're into this sort of thing and you wanna see how we took our entire home off grid, check out this video right here. And if not, this video right here is even better for you according to YouTube, and we'll see you on that one.